Hi, my name is Alissa, and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum, and I want to welcome you to Part 2 of Doing Science with Kids. If you didn't see Part 1, that's okay, you'll still be fine, but if you'd like to watch it, scroll on back to April 28th, that's when it was posted. So in today's video, we're going to be giving you some practical tips and suggestions on things to do while doing science experiments with your kids. We'll be giving you ideas on the kinds of questions you can ask, and also pointing out some skills that your child will be learning when you do science together. I'm sitting outside today because, well, first of all, it's a beautiful day. But second, I wanted to remind myself that some really great science can happen while you're outdoors. And the first thing I want to do is share with you a story of some science that happened while I was out with my niece many years ago, outside, just going for a walk down the sidewalk. One day I was out walking with my niece, who was about 6 years old at the time. As we walked along, we spotted a huge pile of ants fighting on the ground and sat down to watch them. We asked some questions. We came up with some answers, kind of. We made some observations, and we wondered about a lot of things. Sometimes we didn't know the answer, but we kept commenting on what we were watching. We wondered, we said maybe a lot, we said I don't know quite a bit. But after a while, it got hot and we got sweaty. We decided to go home and have a snack and maybe talk about the ants some more. Now you might listen to this story and think, well, that's cute, but you weren't really doing science. I disagree. We were doing things like observing and communicating and investigating. Assuming that if you're watching this, you are the Children's Museum's target audience, you have a young child somewhere in your life, and that's who you're doing science with. When many adults think of science, they think of their high school or college classes. Those are the clearest and most recent in their memories. But college chemistry is not the science that you do with a first grader. So what does science look like for kids of that age? It's looking at colors and shapes and observing animals. It's doing things like building and mixing weird things together. A lot of people worry that science is going to be expensive, but it doesn't have to be. When you do science with kids, your tools are things like food coloring and toothpicks and Play-Doh, cardboard boxes. Some people worry that science is going to be messy, but it doesn't have to be. On the other hand, it's really kind of fun when it is. Science can be spontaneous, like the story of the ants with my niece. But one thing's for sure, science with kids does not look like beakers and test tubes and a lot of complicated formulas. But I think that's enough talking. Let's do some science. Let's try an experiment. We're going to mix some things together. I've got some vinegar and baking soda. Have you seen these things before? Do you know what we do with vinegar and baking soda? Can you describe them? What do they look like? What do they smell like? And we're gonna mix these things together. What do you think will happen? Okay, are you ready? There's our vinegar. And here comes the baking soda. Oh my gosh, look at it go. Oh, it's overflowing. That's so cool.
It's really fizzy.
Still going.
What did you notice? Have you seen anything like this before? Can you describe what happened? What did you see, or hear, or smell, or feel? What can we try next? What can we do differently? What if we add more vinegar to this bowl? What if we do the experiment again with less vinegar, or more vinegar, or less baking soda? There's lots of ways we can change up this experiment. Let's do it again. Take a look at these questions. Do they have anything in common? Maybe you'll notice that most of them start with the word, what? And all of them are questions that a child can answer based on their own observations and experiences. We love what questions. When we're training staff on how to do science with kids, we tell them, if you can't think of anything else to say, ask, what did you notice? Or, what happened when you did that? You can't go wrong with those questions. We're not big fans of why questions. It's not really fair to ask a child, or anyone really, for answers that require prior knowledge, especially if that knowledge is over their age level and experience. So I know you're thinking, I know my kid is just going to keep asking why. When that happens to me, I'll usually say something like, well, it's actually pretty complicated. What I really want you to learn today is how to be a good scientist by practicing good science skills like predicting and observing. And I know there's going to be that kid who's just going to keep saying, but why? And to that, I might give a really simple explanation of what's going on. Or I might say, I don't know. There's absolutely nothing wrong with saying you don't know if you don't know. You can offer to look it up together sometime later when you're at the library or go check online for a good science site for kids. But don't make a big deal out of it. They might forget about it later and move on to something else. That's totally fine. Remember, what we're really interested in here is those science skills. And here they are. Now, charts and graphs are nice, but I'd rather look at pictures of kids actually using those skills. Curiosity. Critical thinking. Creativity. Persistence. Problem solving. Analytical reasoning. Developing a craft. Collaboration. Perspective taking. Envisioning. Experimenting. Investigating. Making connections and communicating. Think about this. Scientists who are working on a vaccine need to investigate to see how that virus behaves. They're going to try to make connections to other viruses they've worked on in the past. The scientists will communicate with each other about the things that they notice. They need to be persistent. If one idea doesn't work out, it's time to do some problem solving. Not every scientific study is going to use all of these skills, but without them, we don't make new discoveries. Now, there's one more thing I want to mention, but we're going to need to back up a little bit. Oh my gosh, look at it go. Oh, it's overflowing. That's so cool. It's really fizzy. Don't be afraid to get excited when you think something is really cool or amazing. We've posted a lot of activities here that are probably things you haven't done before, and they are pretty cool. Now, I have more experience than most in acting excited about things that I've seen a million times before. But here's the trick. The kids haven't seen it a million times before. And for me, and I hope for you, when you see the look on their faces on making some great discovery, that is cool.